The volley is a key shot in tennis, but many times it is less practiced or seldom used. Good volleys can help you be more aggressive and win many points at the net. In this episode, USPTA Master Professional Rick Macy will help you develop a winning volley.
Hi, I'm Rick Macy, and you're watching On Court with USPTA. A lot of times, you know, people think you play the net with your hands. I like to tell everybody, you volley with your feet. You're gonna be in a more stable, balanced position if you volley with your feet. So having great footwork at the net is imperative. Timing your split step is the key. Right before contact, you have to take a little bounce. That way, if you time it correctly, when you hit the ground, you can kind of go either direction. You show me someone with a great split step and they're gonna react much faster. So let me throw a few balls at you. So it's right before I hit it, a little bounce. Good, nice athletic position. Good, all right, that's it. Good, right before I hit it, good. That's it, a little bounce, good. Everything's forward from the athletic position, much better. You want to take a little bounce right before your opponent makes contact. When you do that and time the split step, your reaction time will be much quicker, your volley will be much better. The ready position is a key element to every shot in tennis, but even more so at the net. Because the reaction time is twice as quick, you got to be ready. What I like to tell students is you want to be in an athletic position. Put your weight on your toes, get the weight a little more forward, leaning over, your hands away from yourself. Okay, let's take a look at your volley and we'll take it from there. Good, keep your hands in front. All right, first off, I almost like to describe it a little bit differently. You know, the ready position can vary to a lot of people, but when you're in an athletic position, your weight's gonna be on your toes a little bit, everything's forward. I want your hands away from your body. A lot of times people keep the racket in here. They're waiting for the ball like this and everything's always defensive. So if you're down here, it's gonna be much easier to just spring into the shot. All right, here we go. Spring, keep your hands in front. That's it, just keep your hands in front. There you go. Keep the weight forward. Excellent. Good, good, nothing behind you. Good, hands in front. Everything at the net is about you going to the ball. And the best way to go to it is be in an athletic position where when you come out of your split step, you're going forward. And if you're already a little bit forward with your weight on your toes, this way, it's gonna be much easier. That was awesome, much, much better. So when you're at the net, when you think ready position, think athletic position. You'll be much quicker and faster to the ball. The eight ball net strap is one of my favorite drills at the net. Too many times players move laterally. What we're gonna do is we wanna move at a diagonal. And doing the eight ball net strap really gets the players to move in the proper direction. Okay, what we're gonna do, Nicholas, what I want you to do, you're gonna run towards the net strap. I want the net strap to be your best friend. You're gonna run in at an angle. You're gonna bisect the court this way. Hit your backhand volley. After you do that, you're gonna backpedal about to the same area on this side. You come right back at that diagonal towards the net strap, forehand volley. We're gonna do it 8 times, okay? Good, right to the net strap, good. Run towards the net strap, attaboy. Again, volley to the open court, that's it. Forehand this way, to the open court, way to keep it eye level, attaboy. Again, close, excellent. There you go, again, keep working. Number 7, close. Good, recover, all the way back. Keep the hand in front. Excellent, excellent. The eight ball net strap really, really facilitates proper movement. By reinforcing this drill, you cut the court, it's gonna be much tougher to pass you. But more importantly, it puts an imprint in the kid's head. I wanna move towards the net strap. If you move towards the net strap, you're gonna cut the angle, you have a better volley.
Welcome back. Let's take a look at one of the most important components to having an effective volley, the grip.
The grip is a major league component to hitting a good volley. You know, the continental grip is the one we recommend. When you have a continental grip, you can use it on the forehand and the backhand. The angle of the racket is orientated by the grip, so the grip is key. One of the most common mistakes, especially at the club level, is people volley, and even though you could get away with an Eastern grip, it's much more difficult when the balls are low. What we recommend would be a continental. That way, you don't have to really change the grip when the balls come fast. And when the ball is low, all you gotta do, the racket's much easier to open up. So, skip with the same grip that you got, because you got continental. I like exactly where you have it. Athletic position, good. Keep your hands in front. Good, open the racket. Attaboy, that's it. Less is more, less is more. There you go, good. When you're in that athletic position and you have the right grip, what we'd like you to do is when the ball comes right at you, try to play with your backhand a lot. See, instead of moving this way, hitting your forehand, try to play backhand almost all the way to the right hip. That's it, good stuff. That's it, super. Good, way to keep it in front of you. Excellent. Holding the racket with a continental grip is gonna give you the availability to get power and control because of how you're holding the grip. When you're at the net on your volley, having a great shoulder turn on the backhand is imperative. But on the forehand, we don't want you to turn as much. The turn on the forehand will be about a quarter turn. You don't want to go all the way, you don't have enough time. So, a little bit of a turn on the forehand, but on the backhand, that shoulder to the ball. Attaboy, way to keep the hands in front. Good athletic position, good athletic position. I like the grip, good. It's only as low as you make it. First off, whenever I feed the ball low, what I like to tell the students is this, it's only as low as you make it. And that's what I really like what's going on here with Nicklet. The ball's low, his knee's almost on the ground. You don't want to drop that racket head, you want to drop the knees. I really like to turn. There's a little bit of a turn on the forehand. Good try, open the racket. There you go, again. Good stuff, again. Not bad. Way to open the racket face. That's it, good balance, good balance. One of the things I really like what's going on here, no matter what height or what speed I'm feeding the ball, he's always going towards the ball. And at the end of the day, that's your goal. You want to play the ball. You don't want the ball to play you. So on the forehand volley, we just want a quarter, but on the backhand volley, turn all the way. Over the years, I've told many people, you know, bend your knees. And that can take on a whole different meaning to a lot of different people. Some people can, you can bend your knees, but you could still drop your racket head. And that's a stroke killer. When you drop the racket head, you don't really get a lot of control of the ball because you got to keep the racket head up. If you think eye level, you'll bend your knees. You do a great job of bending anyways, but if you say, I'm going to keep it eye level, you'll always be in a real good balanced position. Keep it eye level. Again. Good. Even lower. Attaboy. Way to dig it out. Keep it eye level. That's all I want to focus on. Eye level. Nice. Nice. Good technique. See, when you keep the, that's awesome. When you keep the racket eye level and the ball's down there, you'll bend. The racket head always stays above the wrist. So you're gonna get two for one. And if you can get anything for free, to me, that's worth it. When you're at the net, you're gonna get the ball at a different height, a different speed, different direction. The racket face is not gonna be the exact same on every shot, simply because every shot is different. So understanding the angle of the racket, very, very important. Here we go. Attaboy. Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. I like the split step. Excellent. Way to keep it in front. Nice, way to massage it. Good, soft hands. Lower the ball, good. I like it, I like it. You can see, he did the forehand volley, but the low one, the racket is very much open. The ball is higher, so he's gonna hit it in the center of the racket. You gotta feel the situation and understand the angle of the racket. got a great drill for you at the net, and it's called catch and tap. What this does is it promotes control, relaxation, because everybody gets a little excited at the net. You got to be able to control and understand the angle of the racket. What Nicholas is going to do here, he's going to hit the ball twice. He's going to have that good continental grip. He's going to keep his hands in front of him. He's going to catch the ball on the strings, pop it up, and then he's going to tap it over the net. Here we go. Attaboy. Catch, tap. Catch, tap. Catch, tap. Attaboy. Good stuff. Good stuff. Attaboy. React with your feet if it's a little too far away. Set of your hands. Couple more. Excellent. When we do the catch and tap drill, what I really love about this, if you can control yourself, you can control the ball. When you do the catch and tap, you not only get a lot of feel of the ball, you get the ultimate control. Understanding the opposite arm on the volley is critical to have success. When you hit the forehand volley, we would like the hand in front. If anything, keep it still or pull it back towards yourself when you volley. On the backhand, it's the exact opposite. You want the arms going the opposite direction. Okay, here we go. You ready? Good. Way to keep that left arm in. Way to separate. Way to separate. Excellent. Good. Pull the left back. Yeah. See, on the backhand volley, you can keep it still, but if you want even more power, I want you to feel the left arm go back harder. Feel it back here in your shoulder blades. Just pull that left arm back a little bit more when you hit. Again. Attaboy. Way to keep it in front. Keep that left hand in. Left hand in. Good. When the ball's low, remember the angle of the racket face. The lower the ball, the more you open it up. The opposite arm. When we do this, see, this is going to kind of counterbalance the other side of your body. But more important, when you feel this go the other way, when the arms separate, it makes the racket go faster. Same thing on the forehand. When you bring it in this way, it facilitates more of a dynamic movement with the body. You're doing great. Then really stretch it back. Again. That's it. Good. Way to keep the left arm in. I like how you stay into the shot. I like how you stay into the shot. Good. Remember, at the end of the day, what's going to happen is, whether you're in transition or you're already at the net, you're going to feel a little anxiety. Because if someone was excited or they're rushed, they're going to have a tendency to open up too quickly. So understanding how to keep that arm in there, you'll just stay into the shot. Biomechanically, when you do that, it creates more torque, more pop, and you're going to have a better volley. When you're at the net, there's not a wrong way or a right way. There's a better way. It depends on the height of the ball, the speed of the ball, and where you're at the net. All those factors play a key component in what you're going to do, whether you're going to block it, whether you're going to punch it, or you're going to make a swing. You got to react with your feet. Everything's at your disposal, whether you're going to block it, whether you're going to punch it, okay, or whether you're going to make a swing, okay? Again. When the ball has more, or the ball's coming faster, you do less. That's when you're gonna do the block. You're gonna use your opponent's pace. That's where the power's coming from. Ready? Keep the hands in front. This a little slower, so you're gonna see more of a swing. Attack it more with your feet. This a block? Good, that's a block. Good. Slow, just keep running. That's it, you volley with your feet. Better. Good, you make the call. Good, back up a little bit. Good. Excellent feet. Excellent feet. Way to keep the hands in front. Good. Good. Kind of a punch. That's more of a swing. Good. Notice the length of his follow through. Because of the swing, you're going to actually have a more of a follow through. It's all situational. So at the end of the day, remember, where you're at on the court, the height of the ball, the speed of the ball is going to dictate whether you're going to punch it, you're going to block it, or you're going to create a swing. When you're farther back, obviously, you're going to attack it more. When you're closer, you're going to place it and feel it. If you're adaptable, you're going to make the right shot from the right spot. playing the net is an art, and you got to have power and you got to have control. So we're going to go from one extreme to the other. This is a great drill that's going to promote the player to really attack the ball, and then they got to change the channel. They got to scale it down, and then they got to totally relax. We're coming off the baseline, going to attack the ball. Then he's going to pull a ball out of his pocket and just hit a drop volley. So I want him to feel what his body feels like. Because if you have control over you, you got control over the ball. Here we go. Out of the air, swing volley. Attaboy. Good. All the way back. Out of the air, set the racket low to high. Good. Just like your ground stroke, but it's out of the air. Attaboy. Good. The ball's deep enough. You go with the swing volley. That's when you want to do it. And a nice little drop volley. Go from one extreme to the other. It's a great drill mentally. Great drill mentally. All the way back. Little variety dropper there. Good. Out of the air, low to high. Good. Get in a little quicker. That's it. There you go. Very nice. Very nice. What I like about the drill is the player has to be very intense. The ball's deep and high. They're going to hit their forehand ground stroke out of the air because you're farther away from the net. And that would facilitate, or the right choice would be a swing volley. So they're going to be aggressive. They're going to load on the right leg. They're going to do their regular forehand ground stroke with the low to high topspin with their semi-western grip. But then they got to change the channel. Pull the ball out of their pocket, relax, go to a continental grip, and hit a drop volley. It's a great drill for players to understand the situation dictates the power and the speed of the shot. The follow-through is very, very important in the game of tennis. But when you hit a volley, it's not as important. It's really a byproduct of where you're hitting your shot. We want the volley short, compact, and abbreviated. So the follow-through is going to be the same. You don't want to overcook it. Obviously, you wouldn't want to undercook it. So at the end of the day, keep it short, and you have a better follow-through on the volley. You decide the stroke you're going to hit. The follow-through really takes on a life of its own. Good. Good. Look how compact it is. But if I give it slower, you can see the racket went much farther. Good. Way to react with your feet. Way to react with your feet. Again. Good. Attaboy. Way to keep the hands in front. Again. Good. Way to open the racket face. Good hands. I like it. I like it. So, at the end of the day, the follow-through, it should be short. It should be quick. It should be simple. You don't want it flowing. It's going to be totally different, obviously, than the ground stroke. But the best advice I can give any player, the follow-through really happens because of where you're trying to hit the ball. It can be used as a corrective technique to kind of clean someone up if something's happening, if we tell them just stop the racket right there. Because when it's all said and done, the volley's more of a compact action, and the follow-through is really a byproduct of where you're trying to hit it. What I'm trying to do here is I want to work on the agility, the change of direction. I want the student to have to really move the feet. No drop volleys. I want them to be aggressive. I'm really working on them to react with their feet and not with their hands. One, two, I like that. Three, four, five, six, seven. Again. One, react with your feet. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Not bad. We react with our hands. And when you do the eight ball twister, it really improves the footwork, especially if you set the rules of the game that they got to stick it and no drop volley. I like to tell everybody you volley with your feet. If you volley with your feet, you're going to be in a more stable, balanced position. If you volley with your hands, you're going to have a tendency to reach and lunge and improvise, and that's going to create a lot of instability in the movement. So think of volleying with your feet, and that will really help you a lot. Hope you enjoyed the show today. We covered a lot of ground, from the grip to the angle of the racket face to timing the split step, from hitting the right shot from the right spot. If you can work on your volley and add it to your game, I guarantee you're going to go to the next level.
If you need more help with your game, contact a local USPTA professional at uspta findapro.com.